गुड टू सी यू लुकिंग लाइक अ नवाब सिटिंग एट होम.
हाउ आर यू, हाउ इज एवरीथिंग इन इंडिया?
वेरी गुड. लास्ट वी मेट वाज इन 2003 इफ आई एम नॉट रॉन्ग. 2017 2017
रिसेंटली
रिमेंबर
इन द वर्ल्ड कप.
वी मेट एट बहरेन इफ यू रिमेंबर, राइट? 2017
ओह ओके, या आई रिमेंबर नाउ.
वी मेट एट बहरेन. सो या वी हैव क्वाइट अ फ्यू फैंस एज वेल. नाउ लेट मी इंट्रोड्यूस ईच वन ऑफ यू ऑल to Sufia Mahmood. He is the only Oman player to be playing in Oman national to be playing in, only Arab to be playing in the Oman cricket team. He's also played for the Qatar T10 league. He was also in the drafts for the CPL, the Caribbean Premier League. He's playing a lot of leagues in America and Singapore as well. He is a left-handed batsman and a medium paced bowler, and he's had good enough time to spend with the biggies in world cricket. And I must admit that I've known him for a while now, and he's working really hard. And for somebody to click his photo next to Brian Lara's wax statue, to then certainly sometime later clicking his photo in person with him, he's clearly come a long way. Sufia, a lot of fans in India as well will be introduced to Oman cricket, and it's important you give us insights and perspective into how it is playing in Oman. But before we get to all of that, are you staying indoors? I'm seeing a lot of videos of yours, some interesting videos that you make.
Yes, nowadays, as you know, in every country, there's a lockdown. So it's similar in Oman. So we have to stay home. And that's the only way we can fight this virus. So being home, I thought of making some videos because I could not play cricket, right? So I thought of, you know, utilizing my time into fitness and some funny videos and stuff like that. So that is like, what I keep busy.
Sufia, you're not the only one bored here. All cricket fans world over are wanting to see cricket action back in the middle. And this is turning out to be very frustrating. But the only request over here to all is stay indoors. Okay, Sufia, a little bit about Oman cricket. In 2014, Oman gained associate status, correct?
Yes.
In 2019, Oman achieved the one-day status. But somewhere in between, Oman gained the T20 international status and qualified for the 2016 ICC World Cup. The qualifiers as well as televised. That must have been very special to you and the team.
Well, to share the story with you, I remember 2015, we had the qualifiers, ICC T20 World Cup qualifiers. And we were the lowest ranked team to enter the tournament, okay, in T20s. And before that tournament, to be honest with you, we used to go to the World Cup qualifiers and ICC tournaments as a participant, you know, just to participate. So in this tournament, we had a feeling that it's very difficult to qualify because, you know, there were some top sides like Ireland, Scotland, Afghanistan, and, you know, there were some top sides. So luckily, we entered the tournament with a win. The first game was against, I think so, it was against Canada or something. It was a very close match, and we won the match. And the next match, remember, that was the match where the momentum was built. We were playing against Canada and we needed 130 something runs in 13 overs to chase. And our captain, who is the current captain, Zeeshan Maqsood, we chased the target in like 9 overs and he was like hitting the ball out of the park, every ball out of the park. So from there onwards, I think our momentum was built and we went on beating all the sides. We beat Afghanistan as well. We beat Canada. We beat Canada. We beat Kenya. We beat all the big sides and it was like a dream, you know. Whenever I think about it, it's like a dream. It was a dream tournament and then we qualified for the World Cup. It was our first World Cup and we were the lowest ranked team to qualify for the World Cup. So you imagine it was definitely an achievement for us. We will remember it all our lives.
I'm sure. For many of you all who are joining us right now live, I'm in conversation with the Oman cricketer, Sufia Mahmood. Oman is making rapid strides today in world cricket. In fact, our current chairman of selectors, Sunil Joshi, was the coach as well of the Oman cricket team. And Sufia spent a lot of time with Sunil Joshi as well. Yes, Arzman, the only Arab to play cricket for Oman. That's, you're right over there. Right. How is this happening in terms of too many expats in the team, Indians and Pakistanis, Sufia, that you're the only Oman player? Or at the junior level, we are seeing a lot of Oman nationals?
Well, yes, in the junior level, as in the leagues, like we are playing, we have like four divisions or five divisions in our domestic. I mean, five main divisions. It's like Premier Division, A Division, B Division, C Division, and it goes on. So in the Premier Division, I'm the only Omani. But in the A Division, B Division, C Division and onwards, there are many Omanis who play cricket, like local Arabs who play cricket. But in the national side, of course, you know, the level is different. And we have a bunch of talented. We consider our Indians and Pakistanis as Omanis only because they have spent all their lives over here. I mean, like 7 years, 10 years. It's like a long time. And you know the ICC criteria. If you stay here for 3 years, you can qualify for the national team. So right. It's like we have a good lot right now. That is why the team is doing well. Credit goes to all of them. We are playing as a unit. We don't feel like, you know, we are Indians or we are Pakistanis. We play as a unit.
Well, is football still the preferred sport in Oman or cricket is now gaining popularity as well?
Yes, football is definitely the national sport in Oman. But yes, after we have qualified for the World Cup and after we have got the ODI status, and after we have climbed the rankings, definitely cricket is a very popular sport now compared to before.
Right. Ayush is saying he's a big fan of Rohan Mustafa.
Rohan Mustafa, yeah. Rohan is a very good all-rounder. Best all-rounder in Associate Cricket. One of the best.
Right. Now, is it true that most of the Oman players also have a day job? They work and then they come later and practice as well? Is it something professional and about cricket life?
Yes, it does. It's very difficult to be a cricketer in this part of the world. You have to go to work early morning, then you have to come for training. No, first we have like 5:30, we have a morning session. Then from there we go to office and then we come back for the net session. And then we have gym session. It's like a long day, but we have to do it, you know, because if you want to achieve your goals and passion, you have to sacrifice. Of course, we are used to it now. Right. But also, I would like to mention our board has supported us a lot. And whenever we needed, we had any problems with our leaves and stuff, our board was always there to help us. So credit goes to them as well.
Right. You made a debut in 2015 against Hong Kong, if I'm not wrong. Your T20 international debut.
My actual debut was in Sarah Taylor.
Sarah Taylor. All right. Yeah. Wonderful. How's your need to ask you this as well. Many questions are coming about your memories in Nepal cricket.
Haji, I went there to play a league. So
yeah, it was, I read about that as well.
Yeah, I went there to play a DPL, it's Dhangadi Premier League. And, okay. It was very nice. It was like there were a lot of associate players who had joined. And you know, the best thing about Nepal cricket is about their fans. You know, whenever there's a cricket match, you will see the stadium will be always full. So the best part of that tournament was the fans were electrifying, the grounds were full, and the atmosphere was amazing to play cricket. The conditions were good, everything was good. I love visiting Nepal for cricket whenever I go there. I've been there with the national team as well, but recently I went there to play the league, so it was amazing.
Right, like Dhami was constantly messaging, please shed more light on your experience in Nepal, and he's also asking you whether Rashid Khan or Sandeep Lamichand. You got to choose one.
It's a tough question. Both are very good bowlers, but I would go with Rashid Khan. But if I want to give a new ball to someone, I will give it to Sandeep Lamichand, not Rashid Khan.
I'm sure you've had some wonderful memories because the timeline is flooded with people asking you about Nepal and the experiences and all
of friends from Nepal. Yes.
Yeah, I can literally see that. And Dhamyu as well is a big fan of you. And if I have to ask you another question, somebody is asking me, if you had to select an IPL team to play for, which IPL team would you want to go and join?
I think Sunrise Hyderabad.
Why is that?
It's been my favorite team since the IPL started. Mostly because of Shekhar Dhawan, Rashid Khan, Mohammad Nabi, all those guys. I like that team. The combination is good, really.
It's a great combination. Yeah. Sufia played cricket now for over 10 years. If you had to sum up Oman's cricket's rise and its progress at the international level, how would you like to describe it?
Well, if I share the story with you, when I started playing cricket in Oman, we used to play on cement wickets. And the outfields used to be like the mud, you know, sand and mud. So I have seen Oman cricket from there till now where we have full-fledged turf wickets, full grounds, academy, indoor academy, outdoor academy, gym, everything. You know, it's been a long journey. You can imagine from playing on cement wickets to playing on turf wickets and world-class facilities. It's amazing. I don't have to go into details. You all can imagine.
Yes, I was reading an article as well that spoke about that situation. In 2007, you all graduated from Cement Wickets, if I'm not wrong. It's then on your...
Yes, that, 2009 moment, right? Or 7, I'm not sure. Yeah, all that time.
Absolutely. I've got a question here from Sahil Mehta, and he's asking me, would you be, would you consider it a big moment and an honor if you get a chance to be in the CSK team and spend time in the dressing room with Mahendra Singh Dhoni?
Of course. Who would say no to that? If I get a chance to play for CSK and alongside Dhoni, I would never say no. Of course, Dhoni is a legend.
Right. We have another question. We'll round it up quickly. The timeline. Paudel Sagar is saying you have been playing with the Nepal cricket since a long time. Did you see progress of Nepal cricket as well in the years? And are you seeing them in the right direction?
Well, yes, Nepal cricket has been improving from years to months and years. But I think over last few months, there have been some issues with their board and, you know, management, and some, because of that, I think their performance has gone a bit down. But still, talented team. They have been an outstanding bunch of guys. You know, they have done. They have achieved ODI status. They have played the T20 World Cup. They have a lot of potential. That shows they have a lot of potential. They have they have support from the audience. They have everything. It's just that, you know, maybe a better management or something like that might help them more.
Right. Absolutely. Akib Ilyas official is saying, Sufyan, I'm your big fan. Can I get your jersey?
He's just playing around.
Akib, I hope you're doing well, because we hear some wonderful stories about your batting, and keep up the great work you've been doing for Oman as well.
Been the backbone of our team.
Backbone, yes. You play some audacious shots as well, which is very nice.
Yes.
I've seen those shots, and it's really breathtaking, to put it simply. Sir, ask him this request. Sufyan, can I get your jersey, please? Are you giving Akib your jersey, Sufyan?
He already has so many jerseys of mine.
Okay, I guess we're completing time here. We keep it for 30 minutes. We have five more minutes left on this. Sufyan, to begin with, wonderful having you. And, you know,
Thank you so much.
Very eager to introduce Oman cricket to our audience in India as well. Because, you know, I was seeing the kind of progress Oman cricket has made. In 2017, I met Jitinder, I met Mehran, I met Khawar Ali, I met quite a few. And you all are a wonderful bunch of boys, great unity, and I guess what's keeping your team together?
Definitely. As I told you, we have been playing good cricket, we have been playing as a unit, we have been working hard. You know, it's very difficult to wake up early morning, go for training, then office, then training, then gym. You know, it's difficult. It's a long day, but we have never complained. We have worked hard always. We have believed in ourselves, and there you go. The results are in front of everyone. We hope that we can climb the ladder more.
Right. Now, and how do you look at your career as well? You're playing a lot of leagues around the world. I guess that has really, I'm sure, helped you with the kind of exposure and with the kind of cricket you played with different teams.
Yes, I was coming to that point next. Me, especially myself, Akib and Jatinder, we have never played cricket in India or Pakistan. You know, there are players in our team who have played good level cricket in India or Pakistan. But three of us have been raised over here. We have played cricket over here. We have learned cricket over here. You know, everything by ourselves, watching videos, watching, going to clubs, going to club, playing club cricket, playing, domestic matches, and learning by ourselves, school cricket, university cricket, and then reaching this level by ourselves is definitely a big achievement for us. That is what I say. I am what I am because of course, my coaches. Plus, I have played all the leagues around the world, and then a lot of cricket domestically over here. So, I've learned a lot in terms of cricket. When it comes to cricket, I've learned a lot.
And yes, it's always nice to see that you're working even harder through your videos and through your, you know, travels with different teams across the globe as well.
Yes, now, definitely.
You know what's happened now? Now that you've told that you're not giving your jersey to Akib because he already has way too many, quite a few on the timeline are saying, give it to me then, Sufyan. Sufyan, looking forward to your team being in India very soon again. Because if 2023, if you'll qualify for the World Cup, then it's happening in India.
Yes, hopefully.
India has turned out to be lucky. Dharamshala is where
yes,
you had your matches.
Definitely.